Hello students, very good morning. So in the today's session, we are going to see about the wing load distribution. So this Excel sheet will fully comprises of several datas. That is, you'll have first the input sheet, and then once you have given all the inputs, that is which is highlighted in the yellow color in this Excel sheet. So you can just fill up all the yellow color datas, that is the Mach number, wing area, aspect ratio, sweep angle, taper ratio, drag coefficient, CL alpha, and then B span, that is span, and then root chord, tip chord, and then mean chord. And then you have also, you need to fill up all the lift value, and then the engine weight of in case of if you have two engines at the wing, you have to give the two datas, that is the two wing data, wing engine data. In case if you have the fuselage fitted engine, then you no need to give the datas. Okay, so you can just give it as zero for the fuselage fitted engine. In case of wing fitted engine, you have to fill up these two datas. Okay, so this is the input sheet. And then after filling up the input sheet, you will be getting the span-wise lift, lift of the flap, and then the fuel weight, engine weight 1 and engine weight 2, and structural weight. So these many sheets will be automatically filled up, and you will be getting the load distribution over due to these factors. Okay, so ultimately you can just collect all these datas with the help of this Excel sheet. Okay, so now let us fill up the input data sheet. So I hope you don't have any difficulty in filling up this yellow column, because you can directly take all the data from the fuselage load distribution, that is the second experiment which you have done in the last week. That you can directly take all the data from the fuselage load distribution input table. Okay, so the same data we will be seeing here, and after filling up, you have to fill up all these yellow sheets. All this yellow shaded portion. So here you can see the lift of unflap and lift of the flap, and then the fuel weight, and then engine weight at position 1 and at position 2, and at the structural weight of the wing. So this structural weight corresponds to the wing. Okay, so now let us fill up all these data first. That is the fuel weight, engine weight, and then structural weight. Okay, so the fuel weight, you can directly take it from your aircraft design data. That is okay for now. And then after taking that, for taking up the engine weight, you have to multiply by 1.3. Okay, so that is the common factor of all the category of aircraft. You can just multiply by 1.3 with the uninstalled engine weight. So this engine weight can be taken from the Google, or you can just search through Google. Ultimately you will be getting the value of the uninstalled engine weight, and then you have to multiply by 1.3, so which is the common factor for all the category of aircraft. So after collecting the engine weight, so that is the engine weight of the single engine. Okay, so ultimately if you have two engine on both the side of the wing, that is on the port side as well as on the starboard side, if you have two engine, one at the port side and another one at the starboard side, you have to multiply by no need to multiply by 2, because we are just concentrating on the one sided half of the wing. So no need to multiply by 2. Okay, so that we have did in the fuselage calculation, fuselage load distribution, we have multiplied. In case of two engine aircraft, we have multiplied by 2 in case of fuselage distribution. Load distribution, since we are calculating the load distribution along the fuselage. So for that category, we have to take the two engine weight. But in this wing load distribution, we are just concentrating only the half span of the wing. Okay, that is B by 2, one side of, that is either we are just concentrating on the port side, or we are just concentrating on the starboard side. Either side, we are just calculating the wing load distribution to the particular wing. சரியா, ஸோ ஒன்று ரைட் சைடு இல்லைனா லெஃப்ட் சைடு, ஏதோ ஒரு விங்கை மட்டும் கன்சிடர் பண்ணுறதுனால நோ நீட் டு மல்டிப்ளை. ஓகே, ஸோ என்ன வெயிட் வருதோ, வாட் இஸ் த வெயிட் யூ ஆர் கெட்டிங் ஃப்ரம் திஸ் டேபிள். சரி, ஆஃப்டர் மல்டிப்ளைங் 1.3 வித் அன்இன்ஸ்டால்ட் இன்ஜின் வெயிட், யூ கேன் டைரக்ட்லி சப்ஸ்டியூட் இட் ஹியர். Okay, and the second engine, if you have the second engine on the same side, on the same port side or on the same starboard side, left side layer and engine trigger, that is in case of four engine fitted aircraft. மொத்தம் நாலு இன்ஜின் இருக்குது ஒரு ஏர்க்ராஃப்டில், நாலு இன்ஜின் இருக்குது அப்படின்னா ஒரு சைடில் வந்துட்டு யுல் பி ஹேவிங் டூ செட் ஆஃப் இன்ஜின். ஓகே, யுல் பி ஹேவிங் டூ செட் ஆஃப் இன்ஜின். ஸோ யூ ஹாவ் டு கன்சிடர் த செகண்ட் என்ஜின். ஓகே, ஸோ தட் பொசிஷன் யூ கேன் ஜஸ்ட் டேக் இட் ஆன் யுவர் ஓன். தட் இஸ் யூ கேன் ஃபிட் த இன்ஜின் பொசிஷன் அட் 0.25 அண்ட் 0.5. ஓகே, தட் இஸ் த ஃபஸ்ட் இன்ஜின் இஸ் பொசிஷன் அட் 0.25 ஆர் 0.3. In between 0.32 0.25, you can take any value of the first engine position, and second engine position between 0.7 to 0.1. You can take 0.07 to 0.1. okay, so you can just take any value in between these datas. Okay, so most probably we will be taking these datas, that is 0.3 as the engine one position and then 0.1 as the engine two position. Okay, so these are the datas we have to fill up here, and then after filling up the next data, that is the structural structural weight of the wing. So for that we have the table, that is green table which is given here. So for that you have to take the wing area which is directly available from the design data. You can just directly take it from the design data of your aircraft. Okay, so design data eduthukitingna, you can just directly multiply with the category of the aircraft. That is you have to multiply by, in case of military purpose aircraft you have to multiply by 9, in case of transportation or bomber you have to take the 10, and then in case of any general aviation, that is for trainer kit and then for some special purpose aircraft, you can just take it as 2.5 as the multiplier term. So after doing that you can directly multiply the structural weight of the engine. The next thing is to calculate the lift of the wing. So you can just take up the lift formula, that is the basic formula. L is equal to half rho V infinity squared S into CL max. So using that formula, you can easily calculate the lift without flaps, that is the lift unflap. Okay, you can just easily calculate the lift unflap. Okay, so once you have inputted, given the value of lift and flap, then ultimately you'll be getting the lift of flap automatically. So that is of around 65% to 70% of the lift without flap. Okay, so the lift flap, the lift flap will be around, which is equal to 65% to 70% of the lift and flap. Lift without flap. So you can also make some correction in the formula if you want to change. Okay, so for this value, for this lift of flap, you can just change the value according to this value, that is in between 65% to 70%. You can just change the value, and then once you have incorporated all these datas, so finally you'll be getting the graphs, that is span wise lift, lift off flap, fuel weight, engine weight, due to the engine weight 1 and engine weight 2, and due to the structural weight. So with these six things we'll be getting the shear force and bending moment diagram for the wing load distribution. So thank you for now. So I request all to submit the exercise 1 and 2 as soon as possible, because the last 3 or 4 exercises will be purely collection of some data, that is collection of some inputs from the internet source. So I will be completing the few, that is 2 or 3 more exercises within this week or by Monday or Tuesday. So by the next week, end of the next week, I request all to complete all the exercises, so that I can easily evaluate and I just return all the answer scripts as soon as possible. Okay, and then from those exercises, that is the assignments you have submitted, based on that I will be evaluating the marks for your final assessment, that is for the semester examination. Okay, so thank you all. I will meet you in the next video. Thank you.